some whiskey in your water, some sugar in your tea? What are all these crazy questions people keep asking me? This is the craziest party there ever could be. Don't turn on the lights, because I don't want to see.
Mama told me not to come. Mama told me not to come.
This room. I think I'm almost choking on the smell of stale perfume. The cigarette you're holding's got me scared all half to death. Open up the window, baby. Let me catch my breath.
Mama told me not to come. Mama told me not to come.
She said
that ain't the way to have fun.
Son,
that ain't the way to have fun. Son.
Someone's knocking on the door. I'm staring at my boyfriend. He's passed out on the floor. I've seen so many crazy things I've never seen before. I don't know what it is. Don't want to see no more.
Mama told me not to come. Mama told me not to come.
She said,
that ain't no way to have fun, son. That ain't no way to have fun.
No. So quiet. And especially here, we're in a new spot. It's called the factory. You know, where you make things. Oh Lord. String. We're in the factory where you make things, you know. American made. The factory workers. USA. I love being, as a drag queen, being right here. Here I am. With this rough hewn wood, this raw wood. This wood behind me, and of course, our dear friend, how best to wear a mask, how best to wear your PPE, PPE. This is a new definition of the word PPE, physical education. He needs a name, don't you think? Joey. Hi, Joey. Joey. Just modesty, please. Anyway, thank you all so much for coming here or being there tonight. This, of course, is the is our last live stream of 2020, a year we all would rather forget, of course. But there have been good things. I count my blessings. There have been good things. I can't think of what they are, but eventually I will. And of course, you know, tonight will be filled with all sorts of pageantry and goodness, and we're going to do a block of Dolly Parton songs, because Dolly Parton basically saved the world during this year, and she saved the world so many times, and she sends thousands and millions of books to children in Tennessee because she wants them to read, and she's just one of my favorite people in the world. Here she is. No, No. Although if you have a chance, you should listen to the podcast, which is called Dolly Parton's America. It's very good. I recommend it. It's a veritable roller coaster of emotions. You learn a lot about Dolly, like how she almost didn't do 9 to 5. Everyone knows that she wrote the theme song on her acrylic nails. You knew that, right? Yeah, she was hanging around. Well, first of all, she learned. In a way, Dolly Parton could be annoying. In only this sense. Mainly, she is a saint, in my estimation. But in this one sense, she could be annoying. She'd never been in a movie before, so she learned everyone's lines. And so I've been on stage with this person where they know your lines and they mouth them while you're talking. It's terribly distracting. Let's just say that Dolly hopefully did not do that. But anyway, she was hanging around. She knew that part of her job description was to write the theme song to 9 to 5. And so she was like, what will I do? What will I do? And one day, so the story goes, she was like, Lily, Jane, come over here. And she had been playing her acrylic nails, and which sound, she was like, it sounds a little like a typewriter. And she sang them the song, and they looked at each other. They were like, well, we have just witnessed greatness. Another example of greatness, Dolly Parton supposedly wrote Jolene and I Will Always Love You on the same day. Does lightning strike twice? Sometimes, if you're Dolly Parton. Anyway, I was going to start with a traditional Christmas song, like Ned, you ready?
Yeah.
Like, I'll be home for Christmas. Sorry. But right? Everyone's home for Christmas. But hey, get cozy. Get cozy. Should we do it again? Is that pushing it? Let's do it one more time, because I like, you know, it's sort of like a Samuel Beckett play, if we just keep repeating ourselves. I'll be home for Christmas. It's so sad. No, it's fine. We're going to get through. I see the light very far away at the end of the tunnel. Or I'm dying. I don't know. Anyway, I'm so glad you all are here tuning in from home. Tonight is dedicated to cassette tapes and lovely people that we appreciate in our lives. I just, for some reason, cassette tapes came into my mind. I don't know. So we have to begin with our sponsor thanks. And the sponsor thanks goes like this. I would like to give a big shout out, of course, to Love Your Block. They are the awesome Philadelphia real estate company that's friendly to the queers and the lesbians. They've been with us since the very beginning. I also like to give a shout out to the Philly-based wine and beer delivery company that's called Quick Sip. They will bring you bottles when you can't be bothered to leave the house. You can be as lazy as you want to be. You can do that thing where you're eating a bonbon, tasting each one and putting the other half back in the box, and they will come by and do a pairing with all of the halves of your chocolates. And also, of course, thank you to the incomparable Sandy Fox Jones. Sandy Fox Jones. One day, remember, we performed in a house party in her apartment.
Yes, we did.
That would be a very dangerous activity right now. Aren't you glad? This is the band. We're all very distanced. Everything. And actually, I just got a COVID test. It was negative. Thanks be to God. Okay, so here we go. Instead of singing, I'll be home for Christmas, I'm going to instead start with our Dolly Parton block. Speaking of Love Your Block, they asked us a long time ago to play a certain Christmassy song, which I think is the first one, right? They wanted to hear Hard Candy Christmas, which actually was not written by Dolly Parton. I know too much about Dolly Parton, but she sang, she made it famous, and it was part of the soundtrack of Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. Anyway, oh my God, it always breaks my, when she sings, I Will Always Love You in, which she did write, in Best Little Whorehouse in Texas, it makes me very upset. Okay, yeah, as I said, she's basically earned herself a Nobel Peace Prize. She put up a chunk of money to stop COVID with a vaccine. Did she really save a child?
Yes.
Who knows anything about this car accident that almost happened?
Google it.
Dolly Parton,
I
don't know anything about this. She saved a 9-year-old kid from getting hit by a car. When is Dolly Parton totally unaccompanied on the street without any, you know, security, and she was the one? Okay, Google this and tell us more in the chat, because I don't understand how that happened. But I believe it, because again, she is Saint Dolly. And I said her imagination library has given away, this is the statistic you wanted, 150 million books to kids. 150 million. So yeah, we're gonna play some Dolly Parton. And we're gonna begin with a very strange arrangement. This is an arrangement of Hard Candy Christmas, because I imagined in my weird imagination that Nico of the Velvet Underground, she got her hands on this song, and she was like, I want to sing this song. And so I'm going to cover the song as Nico might imagine Dolly Parton would want her to sing it, to make it different. Anyway, wish us luck. Here it comes. Maybe I'll dye my hair. Hey, maybe I'll move somewhere. Maybe I'll get a car. Maybe I'll drive so far that I'll lose track. Me, I'll bounce right back. Maybe I'll sleep real late. Maybe I'll lose some weight. Maybe I'll clear my junk. Maybe I'll just get drunk on apple wine. Me, I'll be just fine and dandy. Lord, it's just a hard candy Christmas. Just lie low. Maybe I'll hit the bars. Maybe I'll count the stars until the dawn. Me, I will go on. Maybe I'll settle down. Maybe I'll just leave town. Maybe I'll have some fun. Maybe I'll meet someone and make him mine. I'll be just fine and then still I won't let sorrow bring me way down, way down. Nice, nice. Can you smell the cigarette smoke and the smell of a spliff? Oh, how I love seeing all of the tops of everyone's faces. It's been so strange. I think it does give one license to really stare into people's eyes because that's all you've got. So sometimes you're like, I'm sorry, I thought you were someone else. That happened to me earlier today. Someone was like, I know you from the cafe. And I was like, I'm in Collingswood, New Jersey. I don't ever come to this cafe. And she's like, yeah, you're a regular at the cafe. And I was like, well, that's sweet. It's like, I want to go where everybody knows my name. But it's not true. That woman was very sweet, but she was wrong. Anyway, so, you know, here we are in the middle of a pandemic, and, you know, it's been a rough time. And I still fall in love with people all the time. And, you know, especially since the eyes are featured, I end up really following people around the grocery store because of their eyes. Or their butts, but mainly their eyes. And so this next song by Dolly Parton is a song. Well, some might say it's a love song for two people. It's a love song for the man who she's so devoted to, but she may also be in love with the woman who's the other woman, whose name is Jolene.
Because you can. Your beauty is beyond compare, with flaming locks of auburn hair, with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring, your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, it's all I can do to keep from crying when it calls your name, Jolene. Well, I could easily understand how you could easily take my name, but you don't know what it means to me, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Choice of man, but I will never love again. He's the only one for me, Jolene. I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do, Jolene. Jolene, Jolene, Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take.
because you can. Yeah, that was fun. That was, it's very strange when there's no audience. I mean, there's a big space where the audience could be, but you know, what are you supposed to do? Now, I want to remind everyone that, you know, I'm not a spring chicken. And, you know, back in my day, what was dangerous was oral and anal. And kissing was safe. Now it's the opposite. In fact, there are many glory holes. I'm sure right down here in downtown Collingswood, and I'll find out after the show, I'm sure there's plenty of glory holes to be explored. You know, because I guess that, you know, safer. It's a question. Someone should Google that too. Is that okay, you know? If the saliva's way down in the crotch area, or your mouth is way up there, please Google it. Anyway, for the third and final selection of our Dolly Parton brigade, a tribute of songs, we'd like to start with a song that's from the Whoers, and then do one of our crazy mashups. And you'll see. But here we go, third and final Dolly song. Come on in, ease on down the road.
Promotion or to move ahead, but the boss don't seem to let me. I swear sometimes I
low. Come on,
he's on down. He's on down.
To five.
He's on down. He's on down.
I heard us. Oh, there's people. There's actual people. I don't know if you have a... it's a very tall space. And supposedly Yo-Yo Ma has recorded here.
My mom played it?
Not you, Yo-Yo Ma.
My mom?
We all love Yo-Yo Ma. The cellist, you dipshit. So let me try to give you a... Can I? Well, Rocco, you tell me if we can turn the cameras around. But I'm just going to describe the space, and you do what you can. So I'm going to say the ceilings are 30 feet tall. Who knows?
Yo-Yo Ma.
36. Oh, my God. I love precision. Thank you, sir. Oh, there's a masked stranger way over there. He's like, well, you're really far. How long is that? You tell me how long it is. Is it like... 70? 60? 60? Yeah, from there to there. Okay. Yeah, and then this is like 40? Anyway, I'm trying to give you a sense that this is a humongous, like a theater opera house. It has incredible acoustics. We were rehearsing, which is hard to imagine, earlier today, and thank you, Ned, and it was like we were in the Sistine Chapel, but a little sacrilegious. And it's beautiful in here. Can you hear? There's like a. It's like a. It's what acousticians call a live space. Woo! Can you? It's like I'm in a cavern. I'm in Luray Caverns, like I was as a small child in the wilds of Virginia. There I was in Luray Caverns. And I got lost, and there were stalactites and stalagmites. I always forget which one is which, but I think stalactites are the ones that come from the ceiling on down, and stalagmites are that come up. I think that's true, but I'm not totally sure. I know that a secretary is someone who keeps secrets, and that's a good way to remember how to spell it. And there's also, there's this thing, that, oh, now, see, now the time of me being alone in my house is starting to come out. I'm starting to what's it called when you have like I'm in a zone, I'm in a rhythm. There was once a time when I saw Lily Tomlin in a sketch, and I remember that she was told that the man's name was Mr. Pfeiffer, but then he came in and he said the P is not silent, and then she said, okay, Mr. Pfeiffer, and then for the whole sketch she had to keep saying, all right, Mr. Pfeiffer, and that's weird. And then I was thinking about the time that Gold Lame has an accent, but if you were to take the accent off, it would just be gold lame. And what if we just went around being like, I would like a gold lame dress. Or maybe this past 4 years have just been all gold lame.
Yes.
I don't know. I think the horses in my head just went for a run. You know, horses sometimes, you know, they buck, which means they kick back. And sometimes when they buck, simultaneously they fart. And I understand why that feels so good. So just when you're at home, no one's watching you. No one can see you. So imagine you can kick back and fart at the same time. You might as well test it out. This is the time. Grab the brass ring. Whoa.
I think it's because... Can you tell my family that's okay?
Yes. Andrew's family. Okay.
Give him a break.
He's just like a horse bucking because he feels good in the middle of the living room. Anyway, so people have been, you know, what's the famous word? Pivot. People have been pivoting, you know, and doing things that are a little different. My friend Machine Dazzle, he created this whole crazy thing with Taylor Mack where the costumes were unbelievable, and he came out like a Christmas tree, dressed as a Christmas tree, which is good casting because Machine Dazzle is taller than me. I think he's 6 foot four, five? Anyway, he's real tall, and he made these gorgeous costumes and set pieces for the holiday. It's called Holiday Sauce, which is the, you should check it out. It's the Taylor Mac special. And I saw him up there on the little screen, and I just had such longing to be with my friend Machine again, who's just a dear pal of mine. So I thought I would dedicate the next song to him. So Machine, if you're out there, or if you can watch an instant replay, this song is for you.
People stare at the makeup on his face. They laughed at his long black hair, his animal grace. The boy in the bright blue jeans leapt onto the stage. Lady Stardust sang her songs of darkness and disgrace. And it was all right. The band was all together. And it was all right. The song went on forever. And it was awful nice. Really quiet and sad. He sang fatales emerged from the shadows to see this creature fair. Boys stood upon their chairs to make their point of view. I smiled sadly for love I could not obey. Lee Stardust sang the songs of darkness and dismay. And it was
thank you. Sometimes you just need someone to lean on. It's hard being away from you people. You know, part of my signature shtick, it's what I do, is I like to penetrate the audience. Not like that, but like, I like to go into the audience and I like to lean on you. And I just recently saw a video of myself licking someone on the top of their bald head, and I was like, what I wouldn't give. What I wouldn't give. So, what's his name again? Ricky?
Joey.
Joey, thank you. Joey. Yo, Joey.
Yay.
Well, oh, I should remind everyone.
You got to get a shot from behind here. He's got his hands on
Oh,
on
is
bottom.
He being fresh?
He
Let's
is.
See. Let's see. Like that?
Yeah, yeah.
You do realize his girlfriend mannequin is in the back.
He's cheeky.
What?
Actually, there's his female counterpart is in the back.
She's wearing, oh. She's wearing a John Falco t-shirt. Buy them, everyone.
And she's angry.
Oh, no. Here comes the flood. So anyway, I wanted to remind everyone to, you can tip us if you want. Go to the Venmo. What is my Venmo?
Martha Graham Cracker.
Don't yell at me. Don't yell at me. I'm feeling really delicate. And Joey and I are dancing. I think the next, wait, what is the next? Oh,
yeah.
Oh my God. This is a very risky choice that we made. But I'm excited. My friend Karen, who's my neighbor, she was like, I think I had a lot of sex to that song back in the day. So this song was originally sung by a Nigerian British woman by the name of Sade. And I remember when she first came out, everyone was like, why does it look like Sade? But it just does. That's how it's spelled. But it's pronounced Sade. And Joey, I'm going to be really busy with my hands during this. Would you wait for me? Wait for me, Joey. Wait for me. Okay, hold on. I'm going to place Joey back.
Don't leave me, Martha.
This may be a while.
Don't leave me, Martha.
Oh, God. Well, Joey's dropped his...
Done. Joey, you're fine. I know, Joey. Pull those up. It's his PPE. His PPE is around his knees. It's terrible.
It's been a PPE.
I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, well... Everyone, just pull your panties down, because this next song is one that should, ideally, get them wet. Here we go. Do anything for you. I'd stand out in the rain. the biggest heart. Sometimes I think you're just too good for me. Every day is Christmas, and every night is New Year's Eve. You give me a sweetest taboo. Will you keep on loving me? Will you keep on bringing out the best in me? Did that pretty well.
Yeah, I think we pulled it off.
That went pretty well. Come on. All right. Feel good, band. Feel good.
Thanks, Martha.
Have I ever introduced the band during this whole time? I haven't. On the drums is what's his name?
Yeah.
It's been so long I don't remember.
It's me. It's this guy.
It's Ned Sonstein on the drums.
Hi, everybody.
On the bass is the bass face. His name is Andrew Nelson. Yeah, we can't see your bass face with your PPE.
It's my neutral bass face.
Very neutral. To my left is guitarist Rich Hill. Woohoo! Can you get his shoes? Do you see the shoes? The ducky shoes?
Baby.
They're so good. Ducky duck. So ducky. And finally, to my left, is Victor Firillo on the keys.
I must say happy anniversary to Allison and Melissa. You remember we did Endless Love after their wedding that night. And also get well soon to our super fan Annie, who had surgery today.
Oh my God, you know all the news.
Annie.
I'm sending some love to Annie.
Somebody has to answer the Gmail account. I mean, what do you want me to do?
Oh, what are you going to do? I don't know. Let's see. Do I have anything else to say about that? It's just nice to play music with you guys again. And we were like, should we play some new songs? Should we try it? And we did. And then I was like, you know what's a great Christmas song? The Sweetest Taboo by Sade. And everyone was like, what? That's not a Christmas song. But then I was like, every day is Christmas, and every night is New Year's Eve. Woo! That's right. That's right. And you know, well, that's one of my favorite jokes. Does everyone know this joke?
Oh, yeah, I know that joke.
You know this joke? My right leg is Christmas. My left leg is New Year's. Come up and visit me between the holidays. You know, if you haven't heard that joke, I hope you're laughing. And if you have heard it, I hope you're groaning, moaning and groaning. Whatever.
Martha?
Yes?
Can I have that shaker back?
You need the shaker? You might want to douse it in alcohol.
It's okay.
Okay. Wash your hands. Wash your hands several times. Okay. So, Rich, we're gonna do a little number together. We're going to do a song originally performed by the Doobie Brothers, and also featured on the show What's Happening.
I will be joining as well, Mr. Soundman.
Oh, yes. Don't forget about Ned. And one of the famous lines from that episode of What's Happening where the Doobies... And it was an episode, a two-parter, where you were to learn about the evils of bootlegging recordings.
Yeah, Napster
concerts.
It seemed I didn't know. I was like, what is that?
Pre-Napster.
And then I learned that Rerun had pressed record and play on that little thing inside his trench coat, and then he got the concert. And then he felt bad. Oh, that's why this show is dedicated to cassettes. Somewhere, Reruns prop cassette is living in storage in Hollywood somewhere.
Yeah. The joke was on them because all they got was a recording of him eating the chips. Remember?
Yeah, right,
it was too close to the chips.
He still got yelled at, though.
Yeah, he did. Rerun, no.
So imagine that I have like a big ho, ho, ho Santa Claus beard on me, because the person who sang lead on this was Michael McDonald. And it's amazing how it sounds. You know, what's it called? Synesthesia, which is, you know, where you can your senses are combined.
Crossed.
Or crossed. You're like, oh, the color orange smells like, I don't know, like a pickle. Or, or the number 5 makes me feel sad. Or... Well, that's maybe not a good example, but
it's when you hear colors or
you
smell
hear
sounds.
Colors or you smell sounds, or you're like, oh God. Anyway, you get the idea. So I feel that when you listen to Michael McDonald, you can hear his beard.
You can.
So I'm going to try to evoke that in the listener right now. So go ahead and just lean back. Imagine the beard I'm singing. Well, you don't know me, but I'm your brother. I was raised here in this living hell. You don't know my kind in your world, but pretty soon the tide's gonna turn. You telling me the things you're gonna do for me. I ain't blind, but I don't like what I think I see. Taking it to the streets. Take this message to my brother. You can find him everywhere. Wherever people live together, tied by poverty's despair. Are you telling me the things you're gonna do for me? I ain't blind, but I don't like what I think I see. Taking it to the streets. 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 Sounds like a duck. Are you telling me the things you're gonna do for me? Take it to the street. No more need for money.
Take it to the street.
No more need for poverty.
Take it to the street.
No more need for
take it to the street.
Take it to the street. Yeah. Woo! Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you, oh audience of socially distanced and responsible six. I salute you. I think now Victor is back and ready to attack. And you don't want that, but to burn him. He's got the power. You could break my heart. You could break my heart apart. You could break my heart. He's got the power. Okay, I'm going cuckoo. I've been chomping at the bit, trying to be with you people. So I'm very glad that we got this in before the end of the year, this live stream. Victor.
Yes, Martha.
Do you have some question for me?
We have a record number of questions submitted, so we're going to try to get through as many as we can.
Setting a record.
So many people have the same question, and it's a rather obvious one. It's a variation on, what do you want for Christmas?
Oh.
So what is it?
What? The question is, what do I want for Christmas?
Yeah, like if you could have anything in the world, what would you want?
Oh, my God, I have a serious answer than a funny answer.
We'll take both.
Okay, serious answer is...
20 seconds for each.
I want this nightmare to be over! Which I think it's getting close. It's been tricky sometimes. I'd like to pride myself that I have, like, you know, I have it together. But sometimes it's tricky. It's like watching paint dry. So I want this to be over. I'm very excited for January 20th. 20th? 20th inauguration. Yes. And I'm very excited for the vaccine to start to mean that we can all gather. And there could be a bunch of you here in Collingswood. I can recommend some restaurants. Anyway. And
then the frivolous answer.
And then the frivolous answer is, my car, when it rains, it smells. Because I don't know why. But I think the rainwater gets in between the window. Basically, if I take a turn too quickly, you can hear the water inside my driver's side door slosh back and forth. And I would like that to stop.
I have the same problem.
Really?
Yes.
Is it that it's getting between our window?
Do you have a moon or a sunroof?
I have a moonroof.
Wait a second. We have a limited time
here.
Sorry,
anyway,
Ned.
Anyway, I would like a brand new car.
Brand new Ned. No. All right, super fan Shelly Green would like to know, really, Martha, when is your next IRL show in real life? We miss crowds, discomfort, sweat, and all the arguments at Latage.
Yes. I'm sure that Victor does not feel the same.
I'm looking forward to going back to Latage, but go ahead.
But Victor's often, because I'm getting beautified by Max Brown, which is like she should be sainted as a miracle worker.
She's right there.
At 6 feet away. Anyway, Max and I are getting ready, and then Victor has to separate all the people who are fighting over, like, benches and things.
Yeah, and then he comes anyway, to me I, and
anyway,
put out fire.
I have no idea. We'll do it when it's safe.
Dana Kerr would like to know, what happens when a drag queen has a boner?
I have thought about this a lot. In fact, when I was dancing with Joey,
oh God,
I don't know which one of us got a boner, but things got uncomfortable. But the good thing about being a drag queen is that you can often feature, do a lot of like buffalo stance, Nina Cherry style. So I guess that's the short answer is I can always turn around.
You're so thoughtful, Rich.
I'll tell you the one time I really did pop one while in drag. Should I tell the story? No, I will not tell the story.
Do it.
No. Let's just say there was a man.
Rich is fondling the mannequin.
Oh. Don't fix him. Oh, I see.
It's like the 2020 version of Adam.
Let's just say there was a person who was very willing to meet. You know, usually when I pick people out of the audience, they're a little more hesitant than I am. But this man, I would say, met my energy and maybe even, like, surpassed my energy sexually in terms of ravenously wanting each other. And so I think we made out. And then I think things started to happen down there. Sorry, Mom.
All right, we have time for just a couple more. This is kind of out of left field, but I'm interested in the answer. John McGoran would like to know, what is the most embarrassing thing that Victor has ever done during a show? This is an actual question that somebody submitted.
Oh, my God. What, let me count the ways.
Yeah. I didn't say Ned. I said Victor.
Right. No, I know it was Victor. What's the most embarrassing thing that you did?
Is it bleeding See on how the hard keyboard it is and for leading? And leaving before the end
well,
of the
bleeding,
show?
Well, bleeding on the keyboard, I wouldn't say that's embarrassing. It's kind of terrifying. I would say the most... I definitely have heard you, like, yell at someone. And I think you yelled at someone because, you know, Victor's nickname is Ruff Ruff. Because, you know, he's got a short fuse because he's, you know, from Philly. But anyway, but I think you yelled at someone in the middle of a song. And it might have been a tender ballad.
It was a bachelorette party. They were sitting on stage at Latage,
exactly,
and they wouldn't shut up during a quiet song.
Yes.
Sometimes you use the F-bomb, and sometimes you don't. That is a good case of using the
F-bomb. I'm glad you used the F-bomb, and I'm sorry that happened to you. And I wasn't. It was just in the moment. I was like, oh my God, Victor's losing his mind. Because I was like.
And that's just because Victor's never played jazz in a bar.
Exactly.
And the last question is, band, get ready for this one.
Uh-oh.
Somebody named Jeffrey Page has the audacity to say, we love Martha and have seen her several times. Today is my partner Lisa's birthday. Could you please sing happy birthday to her?
Who is this loser?
Jeffrey Page, no relation to Jimmy, I'm sure.
And what's his dumb girlfriend wife's name?
Lisa.
Shall we?
We shan't.
Yes.
Yes?
Lisa, it's not your fault that Jeffrey is a stone-cold idiot. But you're going to be the victim now. No one will ever forget your name, Lisa. Oh, I don't give a shit about your birthday, Lisa. No, I don't.
We don't give a shit about your birthday.
Everyone here was born. It's not amazing. So if I don't know you, why would I care? And why would I sing a song to you? Why would I give a shit about you? I'm so sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry, Lisa. But you know something, I bet Jeffrey loves you very much, so maybe he can sing you, I don't know, happy birthday, but I don't give a shit about your birthday, no, no.
We don't give a shit about your birthday, no, no.
And I don't give a shit about your birthday, no, I don't.
We don't give a shit about
no, I don't.
Your birthday.
Somebody else might give a shit, but I don't. No.
How
no,
old
no.
are you now? How old
I'm not a birthday
now?
Clown. I'm not a birthday
now?
Clown. Day the world goes down and down. I am not a birthday clown.
I don't give a shit about you.
Understand, Lisa, Jeffrey, I don't want you to feel bad, but I want you to feel
ashamed.
I want you to feel contrite. No, you learn. I mean, you know, we've got to communicate if we're going to know what everyone is feeling. So, you know, I just wanted to communicate my feelings to you. Anyway, I think the next thing we have is a force Martha to sing a song. Okay. Now, we have two of them tonight, and the other one I had never seen until about Tuesday. You might not have heard of this other song that we're going to do later, but this song, I have a feeling you know. And we're gonna do it right now as best we can, as best Zeus and Poseidon will allow. Oh, that's a good question. This song was requested by Nicholas Stanley, who also has a question for me, which was...
Yeah, he got a song or a question.
Oh, well, should I ask the question? Do I ever get cold feet before a show? And if so, how did I overcome?
We draw straws and the short has to warm his feet.
Exactly. Someone in the band warms my feet.
No.
Every performer gets cold feet. Yeah, that's par for the course.
We have a foot fluffer.
I don't have a foot fluffer. No, in fact, when I get cold feet, I think the most important thing is to get through the first song. And I once had an acting teacher whose name is Richard Pinter, no relation to Harold Pinter, the playwright. And he said, if you're nervous, give it to the other person. And so when he was talking about our scene partner, because if you're nervous, you just give it to them. You send them the energy and they'll take it and it'll become a thing. And since the audience is normally my scene partner, I try to give all the energy and then it starts to become a flow. So is that a good answer to the question? When I get cold feet, I give all the nervous energy to the audience, and then they give it back in a beautiful hurricane tornado like some out of The Wizard of Oz, which we'll be mentioning later. Don't forget about The Wizard of Oz. Okay. Strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, filling my whole life with his words, killing me softly with his song. I heard he had a sweet song. I heard he had a style. And so I came to see him and listen for a while. And there he was, this young boy, a stranger to my eyes, strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life with his words, killing me softly. I got all flushed with fever, embarrassed by the crowd. I felt he found my letters and read each one out loud. I prayed that he would finish, but he just went right on, strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my
was killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life with his words, killing me softly with his song.
I am Andromeda. I am chained to the rock, and I am ready for the Kraken to come and eat me in a sacrifice. And also for Santa Claus to come along and rescue me with his reindeer. Oh, look, there's a winged creature with four legs up there in the sky. A four-legged winged creature named Pegasus.
I want to be a dentist.
And he is coming with Perseus to rescue me. Because I need rescuing. Oh. Oh, Clash of the Titans. I love that movie.
The little owl.
There's a part where Harry Hamlin is wearing just, I think, a
loincloth.
A skirt or a loincloth. Maybe a skirt and a loincloth.
A loincloth.
He's all oily and sweaty. And he's training to become a great warrior. And I'm just sitting with my maids and ladies in waiting, brushing my goddamn hair, waiting for life to get a little more interesting. So of course it does get more interesting when they tie me up on this rock and everyone's like, look, it's Andromeda. She looks just like Dolly Parton. And I stand upon the rock, ready to sacrifice myself for my city-state. And I sing this song so that the sea nymphs can hear me. Some boys kiss me, some boys hug me, I think they're okay. If they can give me proper credit, I just walk away. For they can beg, and they can plead, but they can't see. Cause the bar with the cold hard cash is always Mr. I. Cause we are living in a material world, and I am a material girl. You know we are living in a material world, and I am a material girl. Choose to put my arms in this position. Material world, and I am a material girl. You know that we
in a material world. Living in a material world. Living in a material world. Living in a material world.
Like that.
That's more of a baton twirling.
Joe's going to pieces.
I do love literal jokes. I do love literal jokes. And my friend once said, what if every time someone said, like you know, one of your parents was like, you can't just parade around here in your underwear. What if you were like, oh yeah, watch me, and you're like, and like a whole parade happened. I do love a good literal joke. Also, supposedly in Pee-wee's Playhouse, or the show they did on Broadway, that was Pee-wee's Playhouse, Pee-wee, supposedly someone gave him a cake, and he was like, I love this cake. And then they were like, well, Pee-wee, if you love it so much, why don't you marry it? And he was like, okay. And then they had a whole
cake ceremony?
Wedding ceremony between Pee-wee and his wedding cake. Or no, just his regular cake, I think. And actually, if you think the revolution will not be televised, you should watch Little Drummer Boy as performed by Grace Jones on Pee-wee's Playhouse. It's so bizarre. And she comes, she's like a package that gets brought by the postal worker, and she comes out of the package, I think. I'm remembering this right, and she's just so crazy, and I love her. Come, they told me, pa-dum-ba-pum-pum. Okay, I have to put this down.
I think you already did.
So this next song is dedicated to, this is a Force Martha to Sing song, and I had never heard this song. I'm balancing too many things. I never heard this song in my whole life. It's called Cigarettes, and it's requested by my friend Dustin Kidd, who I used to do Pilates with at the gym. Remember that? He has two incredible tattoos. I think he's a, what is that? Is he a Libra? I don't know. Whatever, it's like an upside down U. What's?
New?
It's a Leo? Anyway, put it in the chat if you remember your own sign. So this is a song called Cigarettes that I'd never heard before. It's by Daniel Merriweather. And I heard it for the first time on Tuesday. And he also had a question. All these people trying to get both forcing me to sing a song and then asking me a question on top. Well, very like, greedy.
It is Christmas. So.
But they are paying $250 each for that.
Oh, shit. I'll answer whatever you say.
Wait, so we have okay. To play, right?
What's Martha's favorite word in the English language? His is embroidery. Well, you know, I was thinking about this. And I would say one of my favorite words is actually in Spanish. And that word is melocotón, which means peach. Mm. Melocotón, because it also has the word loco in it. But it also, it sounds like a, it has percussion. It's like rhythmic. It's like melocotón. Exactly, exactly. But that's cheating. What? Okay,
it's a crazy
if I had to
apple.
Think of a Spanish.
It's a crazy apple.
It's a crazy apple. It's a melocotón. But if I had to think of my favorite word in English, oh, God. What about, I'm just thinking of fancy words like vicissitudes, but I don't like that word. What about, I know. What about miasma? Is that how you say that? Miasma. Isn't that like a crazy, like...
Oh, miasma.
No, I think it's like when you're stuck in a crazy forest. But also, I don't love asthma. Should we just play this song?
Yeah.
All right, here it is. It's called Cigarettes.
And you get asthma.
And this is going out to Dustin Kidd. Wasn't gonna drink tonight, then I went to a bar. I wasn't gonna start that fight, but they pushed me way too far. And ooh, you will never know. Ooh, you would never know. Wasn't gonna watch the game, now I'm shouting at the ball. I checked my phone and saw your name, so I must have missed your call. I wasn't gonna place that bet, but they said it'd take the fault. Now my clothes smell like cigarettes, but I don't smoke at all. Ooh, you will never know. Never know. Oh, and I was out, I was having fun, and I was out of line. When I thought I was staying young, I was staying out of my mind. Life is like an old cassette that you can't rewind. Now my clothes smell like cigarettes, and it happens all the time. Never know. Love and sex and TV sets, we never left my room. I used to speak of old regrets. Maybe I spoke too soon. I thought that I did my best. Now I know that isn't true. 'Cause my clothes smell like cigarettes, and they used to smell like you. I had a river I could skate away on. I think it's time for me to tell one story very briefly, very briefly. I dated this man in college, and I always sworn to myself, I was like, self, you're never going to date someone who smokes cigarettes, because those are gross. And really, they are gross. But it's funny how the human body and brain can turn on a dime. And because Jake smoked, and because he was a good kisser, by the transitive property of math, I was very excited by the smell of cigarette smoke. What a betrayal to my higher self. And later we had a terrible breakup. I don't need to tell you all about that. I thought I had the last word, and then I didn't. I threw his clothes at him. I ate a lot of ice cream with my friend Shannon Brigman. I think we each ate a pint of ice cream. I hope we did. Anyway. Oh, it's time for there's a video.
It's our From the Archives moment. Band, play the From the Archives song.
One, two, three, and...
It's archives, 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 archives. It's a hootin' and a hittin' and a hootin' and a A to the R to the C to the H to the I to the V to the E to the S. Archives, 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 archives. I'm okay.
A little advanced notice, maybe.
We still got it.
We love doing these Q&As during the real show. It's a good way for me to interact with you when you're stuck over there and I'm over here, and it's like, touch my hand. Touch me, it's so easy to leave me. Okay. You know, here I am stuck with the band. Well, I love this band. Anyway, we actually once did a Q&A session during a live in-person show, but it was not for grown-ups. It was a show for kids, so we're gonna roll a clip from Byron Karabatsos. I hope he's watching. Byron Karabatsos made this awesome documentary called A Drag Queen for Kids. You can see the full version on Vimeo. But here we go. Here's a little clip of the Q&A. Roll the tape, Rocco.
Does anyone have a question for me? It's time for the Martha Graham Cracker question and answer session.
Oh, you have a question?
You like green. That is a good statement. So if I were to say, do you like green? You would say, I like green. You would say yes. Man, you're smart. You're smart. And you got Mr. Green jeans on over there. Wait, are there questions back here? Right here. There's a princess. Hello, what's your question?
Hello.
Things are getting pretty abstract. I prepared a Elvis. It is a color of the rainbow, along with violet. Yes, blue. Blue it is. Blue it is. You can turn that into a question if you want. Am I blue?
No.
You can draw a princess crown. Well. I didn't see your head. Okay. You know, that's also a statement, but I love it. I can also draw a princess crown. What's your question? A zebra cover, right? No, no. Oh, you want me to ride on the zebra? You want your money back because there's...
Hello. We're back. I was trying to put the sculpture back together that I broke, and I don't know if I have the arms to do it. But that's okay. You know what? When life hands you a hand, that's handy.
Make lemonade.
I'm gonna arm myself with a better joke next time. Sorry. Okay. It's time to be serious.
Cream
because
corn.
The next song is a song I would like to dedicate to my friend Stephanie. Stephanie Haynes. Who loves Brandi Carlile so much. And I also love Brandi Carlile. And if you have not checked out Brandi Carlile singing Down to You during Joni Mitchell's 75th birthday party, you really should. But not right now, you're watching a show. But after you're done, go ahead and Google that. Because she has that like high fluty voice. Supposedly, Stephanie told me that her trick is she chews gum. It keeps the saliva moving. But she's, oh, the way she sings, everything comes and goes, like my lovers and styles of clothes. Such a beautiful song. Anyway, okay, but this song is by Brandi Carlile, and it is called The Joke. Oh, and I'm also gonna, if I can double dedicate, because this is a sort of polyamory situation anyway, I also would like to dedicate this to my friend James Iams, an incredible playwright, but who was like, this song blew my mind this year. This song is called The Joke. You're feeling nervous, aren't you, boy? With your quiet ways, your impeccable style. Don't let them ever steal your joy or your gentle ways to keep them from running wild. They come to kick dirt in your face, to dress you down, tell you that your place is in the middle. And they hate the way you shine. I see you tugging at your shirt, trying to hide inside of it, hide how much it hurts. Let them laugh while they can. Let them spare. Let them scatter. Discouraged, don't you, girl? it's your brother's world for a little while longer. You gotta dance in the devil in the river to kick the stream. Call it living the dream. They call it kicking the ladder. They come to kick dirt in your face, to call you weak, and then displace you after carrying your baby on your back across the desert. You see your eyes behind your hair, and you're looking tired, but you don't look scared. Let them laugh while they can. Let them spin. Let them scatter in the wind. I have been in the movies. I've seen how it ends. Jokes on them. Let them laugh. The movies, I've seen how it ends. Jokes on them. Oh, 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 oh. Let them. Thought that song was about bullies. You know, the people in high school who were the bullies, and you were like, I'll never be as cool as them. And then it's really true. I don't think it's just something from the movies, that when you go back for the reunion, you're like, what happened to that person? I thought they were the winningest winner in the world. They were the king and queen of the school. And now, look at them.
They're all biffs.
They're all biffs, exactly. If you've seen Back to the Future recently, incidentally, my first CD that I ever bought. Bam, 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 bam. You feel the power? That's the power of love.
Wow.
Oh, my God. That's an incredible performance by
Huey.
But also Christopher Lloyd.
Oh, yes.
I mean, how does that man sleep at night? Because his eyes are always like... As that character, he's always bugged out. It's so crazy.
Taxi as well.
Wow. 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 A flux capacitor. Anyway. All right. So, I want to wrap things up. So I want to give one more big shout out to our presenting sponsor, Love Your Block. Love Your Block. And I want to thank Rocco for making this all possible. And,
can I thank Tommy to provide the he provided the factory?
Of course, we can thank those thanks. Wait, they're on the next page. I want to thank Craig Kaufman on the sound. I want to thank Benaya Snyder. I want to thank Dustin Windisch. Which dish is Windisch? This dish. He was like, I've heard them all. I want to thank Rocco Michaela. That's you. Dom Malandro. Dom Malandro. Is he Italian? Probably. Dom Malandro. And of course, we want to thank Tom Marchetti.
Yes.
And the factory. And of course, I want to thank the band. And let's, you know, y'all.
Max Brown for making your beautiful costume.
Of course, I want to thank Max Brown for this gown by Brown for making me look so good. I look like a Christmas present that's just ready for you to open with a boner that you'll never see. And thank God for crinolines. Thank you, Max Brown. And thank you all for watching. You in TV land. And here's the last song. So, you know, if you feel like getting up and dancing, you can. But this is a song like, well, if you're going to go crazy, might as well lean into it. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life. Electric word life. It means forever. That's a mighty long time. But I'm here to tell you, there's something else. The afterworld. A world of never-ending happiness. You can always see the sun, which sounds annoying, day or night. So when you call up that shrink in Beverly Hills, you know the one, Doctor, everything will be all right, 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 right. Instead of asking how much of your time is left, ask him how much of your mind, baby. Because in this life, things are much harder than the afterworld. This life, you're on your own. And if the elevator tries to break down, go crazy and punch a higher floor. If you don't like the world you're living in, take a look around you. At least you got friends. I call my old lady for a friendly word. She picked up the phone, dropped it on the floor. Ah, is all I heard. Are we gonna let the elevator break us down? Oh, no, let's go. Let's go crazy. Let's get nuts. Let's look for a purple banana till they put us in the trap.
Let's go!
All excited, but we don't know why. Maybe it's 'cause we're all gonna die. But when we do, what's it all for? You better live now before the grim reaper come knocking on your door. Tell me, are we gonna let the elevator break us down? Oh, let's go crazy. Let's get nuts.
Let's go!
Like everything will be all right. Ain't everything go wrong. Thrills and chills and daffodils. Hang your children. Hang your children. Hang your children. Oh! Hang your children. Hang your children. Hang your children. Hands up, children! Hands up, children! Hands up, children! Hands up, children! You can do it! Hands up, children! Hands up, children! I see the light! See the light! I see the light at the end of the COVID tunnel! I see the light!
Christmas.
Oh, no. Is it okay? Did it?
Karma is thinking it's usually Victor destroying himself.
Yes.
It's coming around.
Did you bleed on it? Did you bleed on it?
Is it okay? It looks okay.
It's okay.
It's okay. All right. Everyone, we're forcing you to watch this encore. I'm sorry. Wow.
Wow.
You know, what can go wrong? Definitely my exit can go wrong. At least I didn't break my leg. But anyway, everyone, be safe. This song, of course I made a joke about I'll be home for Christmas. Yeah, whether you like it or not. But you know, we're cresting that hill, aren't we? We're cresting the hill. 2021 is coming on the run. 2021, you're gonna be all right, all right. So, if that's true, then, you know, we just got a little while longer to hunker down with a hunk of cheese. Hunker, burning love. Mainly what I want to say is, squeeze the ones you love, especially if they're in your pod. Make sure you check in on your extroverts, because they're the ones who are really hurting. Introverts are fine. They're like, this is the best. But check in on your extroverts. And know that we will be thinking of you, because we can't believe we have the good fortune of getting to do this. It's such an honor to perform for you. And a lot of love to Ned, Andrew, Rich, and Victor, and my girl Max. All right. Here's a song that's called I'll Be Home. Remember, baby, you can always count on me. I'll be home. I'll be home. I'll be home. Comfort you, see you through. Hooray! Candy cane.
They said encore. More encore.
Encore. This is. I'm really getting masculine with my guitar playing. Now I'm gonna play. Put on your mask, new mask man. Okay, we got one more song for you tonight. And that's a song from Hedwig and the Angry Inch. And it's a great song. It's the finale, which he wrote. You guys know this. He wrote it like in an emergency. He wrote it in like less than 24 hours. Anyway, what do I do with this candy cane?
Don't ask me.
I'm just going to leave it over
Why
here.
Don't you just smash it into my laptop?
I'm going to put it on, I'm going to lick it. I'm going to lick it and put it on your laptop. All right, so thank you all. It's so weird being in this big auditorium with none of you here, but you're here in spirit. Be nice to each other. Share that bench. And we'll see you in 2021. Have a saucy holiday. Suddenly
you
Good night.
Broken stick.
Nice Allman Brothers ending, Rich.